Python tutorials. My name is Srinivas. In this session, I am going to discuss about creating objects in Python. Creating objects in Python. How to create an object? The first question is, what is the class? Here the class means, the first question is class. After creating a class, we can define the object. Now, first, what is class? A collection of variables and methods. And methods is called a class. Now, what is object? After creating a class, we are declaring an object. Once we create a class, we create the object. What is object? The instance of the class is called a object. The instance of the class or the blueprint of the class is called a object. We are creating the blueprint. The instance of the class is called the object. Now, what are the built-in classes? What are the user-defined classes? For example, how to declare a class? Object means the instance of the class is called a object. The declaration syntax is, and here object name equal to class name and with parentheses. This is completely syntax. Object name equal to class name. Once we create a class, then we create the number of objects. For example, example one, here we are declaring the object. And once we creating a class, and then create the number of objects. Once we create a class, and then create any number of objects of that class. We can create any number of objects of that class. Now the declaration syntax is object name and class. For example, here we are declaring one object S1 equal to sample class. S1 is an object name. Okay. Sample is a class name. This class is already created by using the class syntax. For example, T1 equal to test class. So here T1 is an object. T1 is an object name. And test is a class name. These two are the user defined. Sample is a user defined class, and the test is a user defined class. For example, another example, T3, S equal to set. Here S is an object. Set is a class name. This is a inbuilt. Another example, D equal to D-I-C-T, D-I-C-T. That means D is a object name. D-I-C-T is a class name of the dictionary class. Another example, L equal to list. Here, L is an object name. And list is a class name. In this L, for example, x, here x equal to list 2. X is an object name. And the list is a class name. We can access all the methods or variables of the particular class by using the object. For example, in the list class, there are the number of methods. These are the inbuilt method. One method is append method. And one is the insert method, these are built-in methods, and one is the extend method, and remove method, okay, clear method, for example, pop method, and the sort method, these are the inbuilt methods, sort methods, and for example, copy method, these are the methods. We can access any one method here using the class object name. Here we can access x dot append. you can send some parameter or without parameter. X dot pop. X is a object name, and append and pop are the pop are the methods of the object. For example, here x is a object. This object is pointing to list class. In the list class, number of methods: append, remove, clear, copy, all these methods. We can access the append method. X dot append, X dot remove, X dot copy, X dot clear, X dot action. These are the built-in class, built-in objects. Right? The X is the object name, the class type, list type. And the D is the object, dictionary type. S is the object, set type. Here, T is the object, list set type. Now the S1 is the object of the sample type. Clear? Right. Now we are creating a one user-defined class and creating an object and access the variables and methods of the class. Now go to the Python IDLE software, and now we are creating a class. This is a class, the one class. The class name is either sample or test. Sample class. Okay, hold on. The class name is sample. Now we are declaring the two variables. One variable is a value equal to 10, and the variable the b value equal to 20. Okay, df, for example, or the read the values from the memory. Okay, now here we are using the, for example, display. Display one method, print of. Okay. The value of a equal to comma sample dot a. Here we can access the value. Print of, okay, here the value of b equal to sample dot b. We can access the variables and methods. For example, def find multiplication. Now here, for example, print of and the multiplication. Another variable. Now we can access the sample dot c equal to sample dot a into sample dot b. Here, guys, this is the program. How can you access the variables and methods? Yes, for example, here sample dot and print the value multiplication and multiplication value equal to sample dot c. Okay, now this is the value comma, and we can call sample dot display. Okay, and we are using sample dot find multiplication. Okay, guys, that's clear. A value, b value, run this module. And here the value of a is 10, the value of b is 20, the multiplication value equal to 200. We can here, please observe this. Here, create a class, and access the variables and methods. It's important, right? Here, creating a class. This is a class. In this class, we are declaring one variable a and one variable b, and these are the methods: display and find. Here, call the display function and call it find. This is a simple program to create a class and access the variables and methods. The same program written in creating an object. This program is written only for creating a class. Here, same program written in object. Okay, here the question is to create a class and object. Class and object. Okay, and access the variables and methods. Now we are creating an object without class. Directly object, creating an object. How to create an object? Object name equal to class name parenthesis. Creating an object name equal to class name parenthesis. Here the class object name equal to S1. Class name is sample. Clear these values. Sample. And immediately create a object of the sample. And then S1 dot display. In the previous example, we are calling the same program in class name dot display. Here we are calling object name dot display. Again, s2 dot find multiplication. Whenever you are creating a class, after creating a class, immediately we are creating an object. Okay, here to call the methods in through object, not the class name. Whenever we are calling a method through object, we are using one variable that is called as a self. Self is a parameter. This parameter is used to, okay, these a and b, are called the given object only. Here the object only. Now we are calling the here self dot A, and we are using the self dot B. Self dot B. And the output is self dot C. Self is a parameter. It is a first parameter of the every class using the object name, all the variables and methods. We are calling this self. Here self, not the class name. Self. Self dot B, because self is a argument. This argument, this parameter is used to. It is used to tell the object name with here indirectly. It is called S1 dot A and S1 dot B. Please observe this point. First of all, here to create a class. Now it is a class. Now it is a class. Now this is a class. In this class contains the class. The class is Sun. This class contains one value is A. Equal to 10, and one value equal to b equal to 20. Clear? Okay, right. And now in this class we are using two methods. One method is display method, and one method is find multiplication method. These are the two methods. Okay, it is without any object. Now here this is the first one. Here this is a completely class. So creating a class is a class declaration. So now it is a class. Okay, clear. And it's in the main program. In the main program, sample is a class. In this class, creating a one object. The object is S1. Here, the S1 is the object. This object is pointing to sample class. Clear, guys? This object is pointing to sample class. And here we are S1 dot display. Immediately, the S1 dot display function is executed, and we are calling the functions with the object name. With the object name, that's why we are using the object name indirectly. S1 dot display means here S1 is a self, is a object of the S1. So now S1 dot A, S1 dot A value is 10. Print the output is, the output is 10. Okay, and the next statement is print self dot B, and the output is 20. And here the next one, and the control goes to the, after executing the display function, the control go to the main program. Find multiplication function is executed. Self dot A plus self dot B, 10 into 20, 200. The 200 is assigned to C. Now here, the C equal to another variable of the class level variable. This is also used to declaring a value. Assign the value equal to 200. And print the multiplication value equal to 200. Is it clear? So here, what is S1? S1 is a object. A, B, C are called as the, here ABC are called A, BC are called as a object level variables, and find multiplication object level function, and the display is a object level function. Okay, guys, are clear? Clear? Now clear, guys? Right? Okay. This is an example of the creating a object in Python. Thanks for watching this video. Thank you very much, guys.